Hello students, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is reflection of light at plane surfaces. We have already read the reflection of light at plane surfaces and spherical surfaces on class 9. Okay. Today we are going to start reflection of light at plane surfaces. Now I am starting from the reflection of plane surfaces. What is reflection of light? When light rays come from one medium and strikes at the reflector, after striking, it will comes back to the same medium, that is in the first medium. This phenomenon of light is known as reflection of light. Like that, this is the reflection, and we have written this term. When a light is coming from one medium and striking on that surface, this is the reflector. After the striking, it will come back to the same medium. This phenomenon of light is known as reflection of light. And there are two laws of reflection. First law is, this is the incident ray, we know that incident ray and reflected ray. Now, first law of reflection means incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal drawn at the point of incidence, lie all lie in same plane, that is the plane of that board. Okay, this is the first law. And the second law is the angle, this is the incident angle and the reflected angle. What is incident angle? The angle between the normal and the incident ray, that is the incident angle. Okay, and this is reflected angle. The second law is these two angles are equal, that is I is equal to R. This is the law of reflection. Now, study the refraction of light at plane surfaces. Okay. At first, we know that the speed of light in vacuum is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and it is 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Meter per second. It is a maximum, and this value is also equal in air. So we can say that the speed of light in air or vacuum is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Now, when a light, when light passing a light to a denser medium to rarer medium, then the speed of light will be increased. Okay, and while passing a light from denser medium to rarer medium to denser medium, then its the speed will be decreased. Like that, when light falls from air to water, then its velocity, that is speed, will be decreased. Okay, due to some internal friction. Now, this is the speed of light. What is rarer and denser medium? I just discussed that. When light passing from denser medium, rarer medium to denser medium, that is, then this medium is called optically rarer. Okay. While passing from a medium to the another medium, if the velocity, that is speed of light, decrease, then we call that medium, which is the denser medium, with respect to the first medium. Okay. If light gets increased. Similarly, when the speed of light is increased while passing from one medium to another medium, then this medium is called a rarer medium as its velocity, its speed is increased. Okay. Now, what is reflection? In this case, there will be two medium. There will be two medium, first medium and second medium. Both the mediums are transparent. When a light coming from one medium, which is also transparent, and falls on the junction of first and second medium, after striking on the junction, the light gets bent into the second transparent medium. This phenomenon, that is the change of direction of light from its actual path in the second medium, is called the refraction of light. Like that. This is a separation, that is the junction. If this is first medium and this is second medium, when light enters from first medium obliquely, and after striking at the junction of these two medium, it will enter the second medium. Enter the second medium, it change its direction. The actual path of the ray is in this direction, right? It changes its direction. This phenomena of light is called the refraction of light. In this case, if the medium is rarer, if it is a rarer medium and it is denser medium, rarer medium and it is denser medium, then it will be come towards the normal. Second one, if light comes from a denser medium and falls on the rarer medium, then after entering the second transparent medium, it will go away from the normal, like in this direction. The actual direction of the ray is this, but when it is denser medium, it is rarer medium, then it will be go far from the normal. Okay, this is the case of when light is falling from rarer to denser. This is from denser to rarer medium. Okay. Now, the next one is when light fall normally, that is not fall on obliquely on the junction between these two medium, like that, if light falls normally on these two junction of the two medium, like that, it is fall normally. Then when it enters the second medium, it will enter the second medium without changing its direction. One, look at that. Look at here, the angle is 0 here. The incident angle is 0 here. Why incident angle is 0? You know that the angle between the incident ray and the normal is called incident angle or angle of incidence. Look at here, the incident ray falls on the normal. That is why the angle is 0. Here also the angle is 0. As there is no angle between them, it will pass to the second transparent medium without changing its direction. Now, look at the first diagram. Here, the lights are coming from the rarer medium and enters the denser medium. Okay, yes, the denser medium. It is known as the incident angle, that is noted by I. And this angle, that is the angle between the normal and the reflective ray. Sorry, the refracted, it is not reflected. This is not reflection, it is refraction. That is why the name of the ray is refracted ray. So the angle will also be known as the refracted angle, and it is also denoted by r, small r. Okay. The actual direction of the ray is this. That is, if there is no second medium, then the light will pass directly without deviation. What is deviation? The deviation means the angle through which the ray reflected. Like that, this is the actual path and this is the refracted ray. So this ray make an angle with the actual ray. Okay, this angle is denoted by small delta, conical delta, and it is the angle of deviation. Okay, now look at here. This angle of deviation is as I is greater than R. In this case, I is greater than R. So it will be I minus R. Why I minus R? Look at here. I is equal to the summation of, that is the addition of R plus conical delta, because these are the opposite angle. This angle and this angle is equal because it is the opposite angle. That is why we can write that delta plus R is equal to the incident angle. From this equation, we can write that delta is equal to I minus R. Similarly, look at this diagram here. This is the angle of deviation and this is the angle of refraction incident angle. Look at it. Here R is greater than I. r is greater than r. So the delta is r minus r. This is the angle of deviation. Okay, this is the angle of deviation. Now the next question. Now, what is the reason for that refraction? What is the reason for that refraction? As we know that the speed of light in vacuum of air is maximum, that is 320 meters per second. Now, when it enters the any kind of denser medium, its speed will decrease. Its speed will decrease. Due to the difference of speed in the various medium, the light gets changed in its path. That is, it will enter the semi-transparent medium with changing its direction. Okay. This is the reason. Now, the laws of reflection. Like laws of reflection, there are two laws of reflection. I am drawing the diagram. Okay, this is medium 1, this is medium 2. Okay, I am drawing here the normal. This is the normal. This is the normal. This is the normal. Now, if I take that this air, this glass, which is a rarer medium, denser medium, after striking at the surface, it will pass to this direction. This is I, this is R. I discussing the two laws of reflection. First law, that incident ray, the refracted ray, and the normal drawn at the point of incidence all lie in the same plane, that is in the plane of this whiteboard. Okay, this is the first law. Second law is for these two particular media, that is for medium 1 and medium 2, the sine of the angle of incidence, the ratio of the sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is always constant. Okay, this is the second law. Now, for these two particular media, the angle of the sine of refracted angle, that is I, divided by sine R. Okay, this ratio is always constant for two particular media. Okay, this is the second law. Now, this constant is known as or written as mu. Mu, that is 1 mu 2. 1 mu 2 means the rays coming from medium 1 and enters the medium 2. This constant is known as mu, mu. Okay, and this is also known as the refractive index. This is known as refractive index. So, this is the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1. Okay, 1 mu 2 means refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1. Now, how can we define the refractive index? From this ratio, we can define the refractive index. First thing, mu is equal to sine of incidence angle divided by sine of refracted angle. Look at here, we can define it like that. The ratio of sine of the incident angle to the sine of the refracted angle is defined as the mu. Okay. Now, the next portion, effect of speed, wavelength and frequency on the refraction of light. What is this? Velocity. I'm writing here. Effect of speed v, wavelength lambda and frequency a on refraction. Okay. V, lambda and a. What is the effect on this value on refraction? First thing is that when the rays are coming from denser medium to rarer medium, what will happen? If the rays are incident, in this case, the rays are coming from the rarer medium to denser medium. Rarer medium to denser medium. In this case, the velocity of that ray in this medium will be decreased. That is, B will be decreased. In this other words, if the rays are coming from denser medium to rarer medium, the velocity will be increased. Now, second one is lambda. Sorry, that is the frequency. What is the effect on frequency? Now, the frequency of light depends on the source of light. So, it does not change on the refraction. It will be throughout same. Now, the third one. What is the relationship between A, lambda and B? We know that B is equal to A into lambda. From this equation, we can write that A is equal to B by lambda. If B increase, then lambda will also increase. For this reason, A is always same. If B decrease, then lambda will also decrease. That is why A is always same. A does not change, the continuum is changed. Okay, this is the effect of this on the refraction. Now, this refractive index mu can be also defined as mu is equal to velocity, speed of light in vacuum, speed of light in vacuum divided by speed of light in that medium where we have to calculate the mu in that medium. Okay, as we know that speed of light is 10^8 meter per second and it is divided by small c, that is small c divided by d. Okay, let d be the speed of light in that medium. So, mu is equal to c by d, that is, it is also defined as the ratio of speed of light in that one to the speed of light in that medium. This is the refractive index of a medium. Okay. Now, what are the conditions for the light ray to pass undeviated on refraction? There are two cases. Okay, there are two cases where the rays are passing from one medium to another medium without deviation. First thing is that if the light ray falls normally, then it will be pass undeviated. Okay. Second one is, if this is medium 1, medium 2, if there is no medium, that is two medium, if these two mediums are same, then there will be no deviation, it will be passed to the actual way. This is the conditions. Now, principle of reversibility of the path of light. Principle of reversibility. What is the principle of reversibility of light? Principle of reversibility. Principle of reversibility. According to this principle, the path of light ray is reversible. The path of light ray is reversible. Look at that. This is medium 1, medium 2. The ray is coming down this way and this is the normal incident angle, the reflected angle. According to this principle, the path of light is reversible. If the light rays are reflected with incident angle I, that is incident angle I, and reflected angle R, after that, if the light rays fall on making the angle R, then it will be the value same in the first medium I. Okay, this is the principle of reversibility of the medium. Okay, now in this case 1 mu 2, that is the reflective index of the first medium with respect to the second medium, as we know that this is the ratio of sine of the angle of incidence to the sine of the reflected angle, that is sine R. Okay. Similarly, if this is reversible, that is the path of light is is reversible, then we can write that 2v1, that is the light rays coming from medium 2 and enters the first medium. In this case, 2v1 will be sin r divided by sin r. Why sin r? Because if the light is coming from this medium, then this is the incident angle, this is the reflected angle. So sin r by sin r. Okay. So we can multiply both this. We can write that sin I by sin r into sin r by sin I. Okay. Sin r cancel out, sin r cancel out. 1. That is, we can write from this equation 1 mean 2 is equal to 1 by 2 mean 1. Okay. This is the condition. From this equation, we can solve any kind of numerical problem. Next year, we will discuss further in this chapter. Okay. That's all for today's class. Thank you.